Why are you watching FSD so closely?
Because the car sale data are very transparent, and it's obvious that the car sales has hit a wall, whether in California, in China, in Europe. So in California, the data are very transparent. Sales down 24% year over year in Q2, and California being 25% of the U.S. EV sales. And in China, it's down 7%. That's on top of very aggressive promotions. In Europe, it's a different story. There's a tariff coming up. Now, the Chinese-made car going to Europe starting this month will face 20% increase in tariff. So at this cross current, Tesla all of a sudden pivoted its story from EV sales to FSD. Essentially, FSD is a story of, okay, you buy a car, I give you a driver. So that's supposed to be a differentiation for Tesla car to, you know, get more share in the market. But it is our view, after speaking extensively to the researchers in the field, as well as the competition's AI effort, that, you know, it's a very immature product. It takes time to get higher quality data, probably a rework of the underlying narrow AI system, and waiting for more GPU cluster for this to work.
Full self-driving has actually been something both Ed and I have been playing with a lot, lucky enough to be able to do so. But why do you think the underlying technology, the overall scale of investment that Tesla needs to make, is so much larger than the market is factoring in? Because this is always the long-term bet, that Tesla is an AI play.
Yep. Tesla's AI vision is a little bit different from everyone else. Everyone else in the industry relies on sensors in addition to the underlying AI software. But Tesla wants to differentiate itself as a unique play in autonomous AI. Therefore, it markets as the end-to-end vision only AI play. But if you talk to people in the area, they'll tell you that it's a very difficult route. Because it needs a lot more extensive data input, and it requires a much more extensive AI system to truly get you to L5. So now you have this very big operation domain design, and you have limited hardware tool, but you want to achieve L5. So that's a very, very tall order.
Speaking of hardware, we were just showing some of the things that are top of mind for retail investors, right? They have a platform, say.com. They can vote or upvote their questions. What's missing from that is robotaxi. How critical is it that Elon Musk gives us a date, a new date, for the robotaxi unveil?
Well, robotaxi, it's just one manifestation of its vision-only E2E, autonomous AI. But robotaxi, in fact, is easier to achieve than FSD because there's no one behind the wheel. So in terms of the legal liability, it's much crystal clear. So if robotaxi gets into trouble, it's Tesla that's going to fully compensate and financially, legally responsible for the accident. As opposed to FSD, as long as it's not fully autonomous and the Tesla doesn't claim 100% legal responsibilities, it's the insurance company needs to underwrite that risk. That's why you see lots of Waymos on the street in selective cities, but there's no Tesla robotaxi because it requires a different sort of like hardware software and AI program integration. Tesla doesn't have that.
We're used to perhaps being patient on Elon's promises. He's pushed back robotaxi. He pushed back Optimus just in the last day or so. Does that matter in the longer term if we are seeing a vision of AI? Look, this is also an energy company that does relatively well.
Well, sure, energy does extremely well, but energy is not something you give it 100 times the price-to-earning ratio, right? So, I mean, the stock is at $250. The company is supposed to make $2.50 this year. So, effectively, you are giving it 110 price to earning ratio. Okay, so FSD story will get this to, you know, where the company, where Elon Musk wants the stock to go. So the math is this. So FSD will allow the penetration to go up to 30% of all cars sold in the US. So US sells about 18 million cars. So that gives you 6 million cars for Tesla, because it's give you a car, give you a driver. So people will buy it for $45,000. And then the company makes 10% profit margin. And you give 30 times price to earning to that kind of a run rate, normalized earning, just like you give to Apple. That gives you $2 trillion valuation. That's the story they want to tell to the investor base and pacify them. It might be true, it might not be true. And it might be someone else get there first, and Tesla is not. But if you give it 20% probability, that gives you significantly less market valuation than $2 trillion.